The second East African Community World Kiswahili Language Day Symposium, which is taking place in Kampala, has attracted several officials from within the East African community. The symposium, running under the theme Kiswahili and Multilingualism, Achieving More Together, is intended to stimulate the use of Kiswahili language among the East African community member countries. Last year, Cabinet approved compulsory teaching of Kiswahili in primary and secondary schools in the country. While addressing the gathering, East African Community Affairs Minister Rebecca Kadaga said in about 4 years, the Uganda National Examinations Board will start to examine Swahili language in primary schools and it will be compulsory. Asked whether Uganda has enough Kiswahili teachers, Kadaga said it is still a huge challenge, but the plan is to have at least 7 Kiswahili teachers in every primary school.
Due to meet with the Minister of Gender Education so that we work out a plan, we now have at least 1 teacher for primary school. They are not enough to teach all the classes, but there's at least 1 we can post to each school. But we need at least 7 for each school. So we are going to roll out a plan, and in about 3-4 years, we shall make Swahili compulsory at PLE so that children are taking English, Swahili, science, SST, mathematics. So when we start with that, we shall have children who have more than 1 language. Yeah. But I've just spoken.
Ugandans have been challenged to embrace Swahili language to ease cross-border trade and communication.
Kuchukua nguo. Mimi nasema, bakasoma, bakuje, bachukue nguo.
Habari gani? Kore kazi.
Network with the youth, specifically the youth. I can see a lot of youth around to take up this language. Be keen and interested to learn the language. Uganda is one of the countries. We have so many Swahili teachers in the country. Once we promote it, also our business community will benefit from it.
In Hoima district, city schools have blamed failure to teach Kiswahili on lack of adequate teaching materials and qualified Kiswahili teachers. Uganda declared Kiswahili compulsory in all schools as one of its key steps to advance the language. International Swahili Day will be marked on the 7th of July.
I had tried to get a teacher, but because he was in private, when he got where he was being paid well, he went for greener pastures. So at the moment, I don't have.
The teaching force, we do not have teachers who are skilled in teaching Kiswahili language. And therefore, when it comes to our UPE and particularly the private primary schools, it is not there. It has not taken root because the teachers who are teaching Kiswahili are not there.
Hali ni nzuri sana kwa na wanafunzi sasa wameanza kujifunza lugha ya kujifundisha lugha ya Kiswahili. Basi nikiwasaidia hapa na pale. Niamua kukumbatia swala la lugha ya Kiswahili baada ya kuona kwamba Kiswahili kinahitajika hapa nchini na ilitangazwa kwamba lugha hii iwe lugha iliyo rasmi. Munahisije?
Vizuri.
Munahisije?
Report by Juliet Namuwaya and Ambrose Nwagaba for the news.
How do you feel?